The hardest part of getting into plugin development is setting up the dang project. In this video, I'll guide you through the process as quickly as possible while still making sure to actually explain what each step does. Just a heads up though, Java is janky and weird, and you will end up banging your head against the wall. This is normal. Power through it. I believe in you. Alright, the very first thing you're gonna wanna do is download IntelliJ IDEA. This is by far the best code editor for anything to do with Java. So go ahead and download the community edition, unless you feel like paying $100 or so for the same program. And once you've got that installed, come back here. When you open it up, you will be greeted by a screen something like this. Now you might think that to create a project, we want to go to New Project and then select our programming language, but no. First, you gotta go to Plugins, and then we have to search for a plugin in the marketplace. This will make our life infinitely easier. Find the plugin called Minecraft Development. Make sure it's the one with over 600,000 downloads. Then hit Install. Mine's already installed. All this does is add some project templates for all sorts of Minecraft-related stuff. But today, we are making a plugin, a Spigot plugin. That's why we're gonna select Paper. The difference between Paper and Spigot is that Paper is about a million bajillion times faster and good, whereas Spigot is the older version that is a separate project and is worse. Okay, make sure the project SDK is set to 17. If you don't have 17 up here, you can click Download JDK and hit version 17 and then choose one of these. The reason for this is that Minecraft 1.18 uses Java 17. Now we can proceed by hitting the next button. Okay, this is the worst screen in the entire thing, because when you haven't done any Java development before, you don't know what a group ID is, and you don't know what an artifact ID is. So what are they? Okay, confusingly, group ID is usually a website URL that you own, written down back to front. So for me, that would be something like com.legitimoose. But I don't own a domain, I hear you saying. That's fine. If you're doing it casually, what I would recommend doing is putting in me.yourname or some unique thing in there. Why is this even here? Well, it's here to prevent overlaps of names. If two projects have the exact same name, there could be a potential conflict where Java doesn't really know what code you're talking about. This shouldn't be an issue. So go with me.yourname. So for me, that would be me.legitimoose. Artifact ID is like the name of your project, but it's all lowercase and with no spaces and doesn't start with a number and a couple other rules. By the way, I put the full standard in the description in case any of you are curious, like I am. I'll call this plugin Extreme Flight, because we're going to be making a slash fly plugin. And for the version, 1.0 snapshot signifies that it's a development version of the 1.0 release. Down here, we can choose between Maven and Gradle. That's the project manager type thing. Maven is more popular, so I'm going with that. They do the same thing though. All right, here's our plugin name. It's automatically filled this in. Plugin name, Extreme Flight. Main class name, me.legitimoose.extremeflight.extremeflight. That's fine. Minecraft version 1.18.1, that's not the latest, so we'll have to change that. Then we can set the description, the authors, the website, the log prefix for server logs, plugins it has to load before, dependencies, and soft dependencies, none of which we need. So let's click next. Then we choose the actual project name. This is just for IntelliJ IDEA. I'll call this Extreme Flight. By the way, don't put spaces here. I did that once and it broke everything, and I don't know why. Don't do it. All right, if you're happy with all these file locations, you can hit finish. All right, here we are with the widest borders you've ever seen. And this is an empty Java plugin. Look how easy that was. It has already set us up with the whole thing. Let's make a quick Hello World program. So a lot of people will tell you to do bukkit.getConsoleSender.sendMessage Hello World. This is wrong, because every plugin actually comes with a logger that will send plugin signed messages to the server log so that you know where your messages are coming. To access that from inside a Java plugin class, like we're in here, all you have to do is get logger, open close parentheses, and you might think it's .log. No, it's .info. We're sending information to the server log. So here we can say hello world. If you wanted to send a warning, you would do get logger.warning. And then it would show up in yellow. Cool. Now, we just have to put this into our PaperMC server. How do we get this into a nice file that we can load into our server? Well, first you're gonna wanna hit the beautiful hotkey Ctrl+Alt+Shift+S. Or you could go to File, Project Structure. Then go down to Artifacts. For some reason, Java uses the word artifact to mean thing, like a file. We're gonna hit this little plus button to create one, and then hit jar, and then go to From Modules with Dependencies. All of these default settings are totally fine. Don't change them. Hit okay. All right, now this output directory is where our jar will wind up. Let's change that to our server plugins folder. If you don't have a paper server set up, there are a million billion tutorials on YouTube. Just look up how to set up paper server, and you'll find out how to get this. So you'll see this plugins folder, go in there, copy the location of it, and then paste that into the output directory. So now, when we build this thing, it will go directly into our plugins folder and we won't have to move it around. Hit apply, or just hit okay. Now, we should be able to build our plugin. To do this, we have to go to build, build artifacts, and then go down here and then hit build. That's a lot of button presses. So what I like to do is hit Ctrl+Alt+S, no shift this time, to get into our regular settings, then go to key map and search for build artifacts. And I like to just bind this to F5. That's my preference. Alternatively, you can click include in project build from the jar screen here. Make sure you hit apply. And then when you click this little build project button, it should build the artifact. Yes, indeed it does. So that is a much better way of doing it. Now you can see our extreme flight plugin is in here and we can run our server and see our beautiful message appear. Yeah, it's telling me everything's out of date. That's fine. Could not load. Uses a space character in its name. Uh-oh. How do we change the plugin name now? Isn't it a little late for that? Well, fear not, because all that information is stored in a convenient file called plugin.yml. In this left side project browser here, you can open and close this by hitting this project tab here. Go into our plugin Extreme Flight, go into the source folder for all of our source code, go into main. Underneath Java is where all our Java code goes, and under resources, plugin.yml. In here, oh, you'll see there's our name. It's even warning us. It's saying it needs to have no spaces in it. Let's remove that space and then build our project again. Let's see if it works this time. There it is. Extreme Flight says hello world. So now that we've got hello world working in Java, let's just say I'm not the biggest fan of Java. I much prefer a new up-and-comer called Kotlin. Now the cool thing about Kotlin is that anything you can do in Java, you can do in Kotlin. That means using the same libraries, using the same Java virtual machine, it will be exactly the same as compiled Java once you build it into your plugin. And because IntelliJ IDEA is made by the same company who creates Kotlin, they have made it very, very easy to set up. All we're gonna do is right click on our entire project up here and hit convert Java file to Kotlin file. When I do that the first time, it's gonna say, hey, Kotlin is not configured in your project. So hit okay. And now we're gonna configure Kotlin. Pick the latest release. So right now, 1.7.0 is a release candidate, so it's not fully released. I'm gonna go back to the last stable version of 1.6.21. Pick the latest one without anything at the end of it and hit okay. Now it takes us into this scary looking file. This is our pom.xml. And this stores everything about the project that we've got here. This is what Maven uses. That's our project manager type thing. And this contains all the info of any dependencies. This contains the group ID, the artifact ID, the version, what kind of packaging we're going to use, the Java version. Oh, and now the Kotlin version. And if we go all the way down here, you're going to see it also includes the PaperMC API. Now, remember earlier when I said that we were actually using an outdated version of the Paper API? You can see we're using 1.18.1 when we should be using 1.18.2. Or whatever the latest version is at the time of you watching this video. You're never gonna guess how we do this. That's right, we change the text that says 1.18.1 to 1.18.2. Yes, that is literally what you do. Now, to get all this to take effect, we're gonna have to reload Maven. If we were to try and convert to Kotlin again, it would just say it wasn't set up again, and you would end up adding more and more lines of Kotlin to this thing. So to get it to actually update everything, we have to hit this Reload All Maven Projects button. Always hit the Reload Maven Projects button. If you forget, you will be confused for days. It took me a very long time to find out that I have to press this button every time I add a dependency or change anything in pom.xml. Do not forget to reload your Maven project. And with the little press, we wait, and you're gonna see it says resolving dependencies and downloading Maven sources and documentation down here. That means it is going to all of these repositories and it is looking for anything called paper API under the group ID io.papermc.paper. And then it is looking for the 1.18.2 RO1 snapshot version. Now there is a version with this name, you can see, because it hasn't turned red, but actually there's a full release, so we no longer need to have snapshot on the end there. I think I could be wrong. How do we find out what the latest version is? Well, it's on their website. That's right, here on papermc.io, link in the description, you can scroll down and click this little tiny use our API button, and then it'll tell you the stuff that you have to add to your Maven thing. See, yep, here's the latest version. Now, let me show you something that confuses me just a little. Here, it says our Java version is 1.8. when it should be Java 17 for a Minecraft plugin. Down here it also says 1.8, I'm gonna just change that to 17. And in theory, everything should still work. But strangely, it was working before, so I don't know what that's actually changing. Whether it's just changing some display setting, or if it's making it run faster, or what. But if I do that, reload my Maven project, and then build my Extreme Flight plugin, then it should still work. I'ma just stop my server, start it again, and we'll see what we get. Yep, everything still works. Awesome. Now let's finish converting to Kotlin, because now we have added all the Kotlin dependency stuff here, we've specified a version in our pom.xml, which means now, if we right-click on Extreme Flight, hit convert Java file to Kotlin file, it will just do it. Or it should. Seems to have done nothing. Let's try that again. I'm gonna try clicking on the source, because maybe it doesn't think this is a file or something. Convert. Okay, that worked for me. I swear I've clicked on that before and it's worked fine, but that's what I had to do today. Don't you just love development? Some code in the rest of your project may require— Yes, do correct the code. Oh! And instantly, literally so fast, it has converted our thing into Kotlin. Notice how much more compact it is. Can we get a before and after here? Yeah, that's pretty good. And that's all it takes to get Hello World working in Kotlin. I trust you can figure out everything else from here. Seriously though, if there's more you want to know, let me know in the comments of this video what plugin tutorials you'd like to see. I'll put a link to some more of them here if I end up making more. Otherwise, go watch my devlogs where I make my own plugins. See ya!